Well, I haven't done a video like this in a while where I've just solo queued, which is usually the worst idea that you can possibly come up with, is solo queuing a Star Wars Battlefront, but here we are. First game of today, too. It's, got Starduster, who is a player that does not like me at all. Again, there aren't many players that like me in general, are there? This, I think I can win, so long as the Luke beats the Vader. Palpatine, like in a 1v1 scenario, Palpatine kind of struggles a lot beating Han Solo. It's usually an interaction that is not in Palpatine's favor, usually, but there's Vader. I do not want to take chip damage. And Luke is running away. So I have to play this sort of cat mouth and Starduster. Got caught being useless. Starduster failed. Luke got fucked up too. That's kind of his own fault. Allowed himself to eat shit. I need to do this very smart. Oh. Really bad. Best I can do here is hope that Luke grabs that more health and do as much damage as possible. He's at 29%. So yeah. That's usually going to be a death there. I don't know. That health. Practicing for a few days. Wait, we're not gonna put it on English. No. British Portuguese is the best from my experience. But someone took Han Solo. That's sad. British Portuguese, Portuguese is the funniest from my experience. You get like the best voice lines by far. Especially for Calvin. Yeah. I'm practicing for a few days, getting my skills back. And I feel confident enough to start doing these solo queue videos. I'm playing for like 2 days now. Warming up, getting used to the game again. It has been a few months. My teammates are following me. They don't realize that Lando. I want to save my power boss.
O Império está prestes a ser destruído.
You know, for somebody who likes to call me a cheater, he sure is not very good at this game. Starduster 2020 or something else, my friends. Very, very not good player, but he thinks that, That's what a lot of people think these days, but they don't. Apparently those are people who have not watched the videos that I made like 2 years ago. People also don't understand that I started doing that out of protest of, like, the metagame itself, because what the metagame was transforming into was this extremely defensive-oriented, boring, slow-play slugfest that I thought was just unbearable to play. And my way of protesting this was, well, if you're going to play defensively every game, I'm just going to spam this game-breaking glitch punch for it. Because if you're gonna make me not have fun with the game by just sitting in your spawn all match, well, I'm gonna make you have a similar fun experience. It sounds very petty, you know, but believe me, you've been playing the game as long as I have, and you've seen the metagame stages through and through. Like, before BF2 came out, that was when the game was at its most aggressive. Everybody was running at each other. Defensive play was there, but it was exclusive to certain maps. Like, Rebels almost always played this map defensively because of the hill that the Imperials have is such a good vantage point that preventing them from getting this was basically impossible. So you might as well play defensively, because they start out with such an advantage. And yeah, the metagame back then was really good, but then people started to realize that the best characters in the game offensively were also the best characters in the game defensively. So, like, the best way to deal with Chewbacca is to chip him down, force him to use his abilities, target his teammates, team on him for one before he even gets a straight. So you'll often see multiple people teaming on Chewbacca at once. And that was like the tactic for a while. It's still the tactic that people use today. But then you started to see a major shift on how people started playing the game. People realized that if you play defensively, there really is, like, no counterplay to it whatsoever. They're just straight up at zero. Like, for Vader, if Vader decides to just saber and just zone out, there's very little that can stop Vader from zoning people. If anything. I don't think you can prevent Vader from doing that. Out-zoning Vader is almost impossible. Like, you can do it with Lando, Han, I guess, but then they have to all shift their attention to Vader, and if not, they're not paying attention to Vader, then they're getting chipped by Boba, they're getting chipped by Bosk, their teammates are 100% going to take advantage of that, and people then began to understand, hey, Vader is this really stupid character who can just kind of sit there and force damage, and there's nothing that you can do about it. And if you focus on him, then you're not breaking through him no matter what. And if you stop focusing on him, then he's just going to destroy you. So it kind of created this dilemma of people realizing that Vader is just this unstoppable character in this game. And the game itself is kind of played around him. He's just out of bounds, I think. There he is. Yeah, he out of bounds. Yeah, Stardust usually does this, because he dislikes me very heavily, so therefore you will see Stardust do things like this. And it was around this time when the metagame was becoming extremely defensive that I learned the TL50 glitch from, his face. It was somebody that I made a video on. Oh, Trash Teammates. He was a big fan of, like, the videos that I made on him. He was like, hey, I'm, like, a big fan of your content, and I don't plan to play this game anymore. So, here, I'm gonna show you this tutorial video on how to do this. And I was like, oh. Well, I'm totally going to abuse the shit out of this. Beforehand, I felt like the community respected me a lot more, but the truth is that I don't give a fuck if the community respected me. If this was all about community respect, then I would have never done the TL50 glitch in the first place. place. If this was all about earning the respect of people, which the feeling is mutual, by the way. I do not respect this community at all, because I feel like that a lot of the people who play this game are too pussy to play anything else. They don't want to play Battlefront 2, which is the game with more content, more characters, a more developed, balanced metagame. They don't want anything to do with that. And their excuse very much is, well, I don't want to get good at a game again. Therefore, I'm just not going to play it. Alright. Fair enough, I guess, but you just admitted that you are not confident at getting good at the game and beating us. The other thing that people have to understand is that it was never about, like, joking them. I don't give a hot shit about those players. It was always about denying them mains. Denying them mains are the ones that I don't target. Everybody else was all out for Cookie Monster and Pilot. Who, by the way, Cookie sometimes plays this game, but it's like once a month that he does. And, Pilot is the one that plays this the second most, and then Sin plays this a lot, still. Whenever he plays something, he's usually playing this. But I mean, he's been messing with everybody that's been playing this game for a long time. And only now, after like the massively long break that I took from this game, am I starting to find this game. Primarily because, like, while the metagame is still, like, defensive-oriented, it's not as fucking try-hard, I feel. Okay. The games that I've been playing don't feel, you know, it's more so just business as usual. Well, Starduster is sabotaging, so, here we go. His way of he's doing the Labyrinth thing, where his protest of me being in the lobby is making the, you know, everything worse for his team. Also, just realized that I'm not pinging him, following the radar ping of Starduster. Where is this Palpatine? Is he going for the... Also, really run the Lycan solo, because I've been playing him so much in Battlefront 2 that his playstyle has really grown to me onto me. The only thing I guess that I don't like about Han Solo is the fact that he's hard countered by Krennic, and he's hard countered by Darth Vader, which are two characters that I don't think you want to be hard countered by. Yeah. Orson's a major pain in the ass. He's very, very weak offensively, but he has like the best defensive tools in the game. For the simple fact that you can just shut down these characters whenever he wants to, and punish them very badly, really. The armor upgrade and armor breaker. I wish we can get some like better players, and ideally, someone that isn't going to throw a tantrum. Yeah. So I do welcome players like Demon Slayer and Hunter and Megans. You don't get better by facing Muppets all day. You get better by facing I also like to say that I hold no ill will towards the people. As well, it's Labyrinth that I want to mess with, because Labyrinth is like a... He's been like a giant meme in this community for a very long time. He calls himself the best player, but like, objectively Demon Slayer, Punisher, ID Hunter, all of the players that are in his clan are objectively better than him. So how is it that he can be the best at the game if everybody that plays with him is better than him? And it's like a proven fact that he is like a massive detriment to his own team. Like, it has been proven countless times whenever he goes against Sin, or Pilot, or Cookie Monster. Because I'm the worst of the four, by far. Cookie is better than me. Ogi's probably better than me now, because I haven't played in so long. And Sin's better than I am. And they all fucking massively struggle bust against those guys. And nobody has anything on Cookie Monster. Like, the most recent thing that happened was that Cookie Monster had, like, the most recent game we played where we lost was a game on Rebel Base against the Legion Spirals, and I'm guessing his girlfriend. And he got stuck with some real fucking losers. Oh god, I have Starduster and Starduster alone, so I'm gonna have to pick a character that hard carries. It was It was Cookie Monster, a player that had, I think, he ended the game with 75 points or something like that. And then he had another guy who ended the game with 300 points. So it was like some worthless Nianum. A Leia that didn't even attack. It was a Leia that averaged 0 points per match. Which is, you know, that tells you everything you need to know. He was tasked with having to kill the entire team. Which, anytime you're in a game state where you have to kill the whole team to win, It's kind of unreasonable to expect that to be a win. I'm gonna have to lure Hosko. I'm gonna have to lure all of them out, actually. So I have an idea. If their Boba Fett is good, that's gonna be a problem. Shit. Oh, we're gonna do that. All right. Okay, like, I died to Moss, but I got, Vader and Boba Fett, which is, yeah, that's definitely worth it. I mean, the Lando is gonna have to beat the boss, ultimately, but I'm gonna be helping him out with flash grenades and supporting my own work. I did not flash him, I flashed myself. He must have ran away. Yeah, he went for that floor hole. I didn't have a flash. Lando, run. Oh, this could be really bad for us if Lando got... Okay. That was not as bad as I could have been. Boss looks like he's really hurt even after that 4 health.
Yeah,
even with Starduster sabotaging, I was able to pull that through. But most recent person I remember me losing to was Allegiant Spirals, who, yeah, he's good enough at the game to do that. Yeah. It's the other thing too. I don't really mind losing. The way how you beat people in team-based games is like your team has to, if the expectation is you win a game by yourself, I think that's really unreasonable, because that entails that you have to, like, super try hard to the extent where you're outplaying everybody in the lobby, you're outplaying the soldiers, you're outplaying the villains, you're outplaying everybody. Everybody. You have to be outplaying their entire team while your team does nothing. You're basically having to be a one-man army, and that, I don't think, is very reasonable a lot of the time. That being said, it's kind of like, if I were to describe that situation, it would be like the expectation versus reality meme. How can you tell me? It really upsets me that Gengar is so terrible now. He used to be able to completely ignore his tank, attacks, but now he's just a fucking complete victim to that. It really is upsetting. Gengar is just unfortunately really terrible. Wait, what the fuck happened here? How did... Alright, that was a bug. Yeah, like, right here, I'm just gonna have... I'm being, like, a one-man army. I mean, I am playing Chewbacca, who's, like, a really broken character. But, I mean... That almost doesn't matter, you know? Like, I can probably... destroy their team with probably Han Solo. I'm gonna have to really work for it with Han Solo, but they're bad enough to drive the character. And now Stardust is taking Chewie, like, intentionally. He's noticing I'm doing very well with that character. But I missed my chance to.
Use sua cobertura! Atinjam eles com tudo que tiverem! Então você me achou! Essa é a parte fácil.
I'm in a really bad spot here. This is really, really bad. They have the high ground really easily for their teammate. I think that's what's gonna happen too. I'm gonna hope that they're dumb and let's go over here. Oh god. That's... Well, I got abandoned. Well, I killed two of them. Luke is... Wow, this Luke is really terrible. I was suffering a bad case of bad aim there. Not as bad as this guy, who just missed all of his shots. Yeah, let's see if I can get Chewie. Nope, I got Lando instead. Well, arguably better than Han Solo, but at very least this gives me room to make, like, really stealthy plays, I guess. The one thing I like about Lando is that he really does open a door for plays that you can make, but the amount of plays that you can make is completely dependent on your team. Okay, they're dumb enough to... They're fucking idiots by us, though. They're fucking retard if they're gonna body block me. He's gonna sell me out? Alright, let's do it.
Vou acabar com você.
Good chip on Vader. Really good chip on Vader. I'd rather take the chip on Vader than boss. This boss, I can kill him at any point in the game. Vader, he's gonna be a lot harder to take down. Something that Bubble thought was gonna be stupid. He's been stupid this whole time, but he shot at me one time and then hid. The goal was to bait out my attacks. He did a good job. I might be able to get up here. Not Lando was really good against Lando was one of the few characters that was both really good against good players. He's really good against bad players. The bad players get fucking slaughtered by Calrissian. Absolutely slaughtered. Get out of my way, fat ass. Okay, two of them are done.
No echo.
Sua sorte está prestes a acabar,
velho. I fucking managed to clutch that shit. 9,000 points. Yeah, if they're this terrible, I can definitely hard carry. Sabotaging. If I'm sabotaging, I can definitely hard carry. It doesn't matter if Chewbacca's following me or not, because they're too stupid to, like, act on that. Like I said, Lando's really good against these, like, really terrible players. Really, really good. So much so that, like, the stealth makes it even better, but, like, I can play it without, like, the stealth element if I need to. It's just much easier not to, you know. They have an Orson, too, which I guarantee this guy isn't going to know how to play that. Yeah, he immediately put down a shield and then just got fucking wrecked. Okay, we wanna, okay, not quite this cool, but we wanna go over here. Okay, this is like bad positioning, actually. This is really bad positioning for me. Come on, move. Okay, there we go. Good job.
Sua sorte está prestes a acabar. Acabe com eles!
The Vader really wants to target me. He is desperately trying to target me. I'm the max trade. Drop them so they can use their abilities. Really, really good position.
Resgatar
minhas fichas! Carregado e preparado! Oh, they got 150. Oh, those Death Troopers are probably gonna be a problem.
God damn it!
Wait, that's still there. Okay, Starduster, take it. Take it. Oh, Starduster helped me. Starduster, you idiot.
Starduster
ended up helping me. And I got fucking blown up by a rocket launcher. That was very close to me winning that.
Todos eles foram todos
I do have a very, very terrible Luke. But Legit's back on my team now, so there is that. Even with Starduster being completely and utterly useless, and he's not in my rotation anymore. 0 points, and I'm carrying with this. And yeah, these guys are awful, but, you know, this just goes to show that if they're terrible enough, you can win a game on your own. Like, you don't need help, but if this was, like, actual good players, there's no way I would be winning this. Okay, Luke is awful, Starduster is sabotaging. There'd be no way in hell you're winning this. No, if you're losing to somebody, like, who has somebody who's intentionally sabotaging, you know? I don't know what target they're trying to use. I do not want you sticking around, that's for sure. He went really high up in the air. And the hook after he's going to abandon the Vader is extremely fast. Alright. Anything else on him? No. Well, there's... I think somebody left out of embarrassment.
Legit, you're not gonna win this, because Starduster is sabotaging.
This is a... This is like Exhibit A of what happens when somebody gets into the lobby and they select me. Right here. Hatred that is so all-consuming that he's willing to do this. And fail at sabotaging. Well, good job, Starduster. You sabotaged, and I had to do that. Oh, Nyanum, man. Disgusting fucking creature. Ugh, I hate Nyanum, man. I just realized I haven't been able to play Darkseid yet. Vanguard's going right to the middle. What, Lando is being followed, and now Starduster is picking Lando so he can run outside of the map and kill himself. Nice. That is a creature. Can't say I blame you for sabotaging a fucking nine, though. Dabble got caught and useless. Dabble failed. Yeah, teabag him! Yeah! You teabagged that fucking disgusting son of a bitch. Legit knows what's going on. He fucking teabagged living shit out of this disgusting, decrepit freak! He knows that he's just pure filth. These are the fucking freaks that I care about. Stardusters struggle about that right now. Getting confused by the trees, Starduster? Why do you flee, Starduster? Oh my god. Oh god, I'm stuck. Stop, Nine-Um. Farei você pagar por sua insolência. Suck, Starduster. Intentionally targeting me, Skywalker. With the most Luke weak team on planet Earth, and you're still failing. Ooh, hold on a fucking second. Yeah, fuck you. Oh, did you fail, Starduster? Is that why you're contemplating suicide? Is that what's going on? You completely and utterly failed and you got cocky and useless, so now you're just hanging out in the swamp, all depressed and sad. Alright, dude. Oh, medical droid. Cavalt is using medical droid. See you later, Leah. Yeah, Starduster could have very easily won this game. He's Luke versus Palpatine Boba Dorsen. The most fucking Luke weak team on planet Earth. Dorsen is the one. I mean, my Boba Fett's. Boba Fett just fucking wrecked the shit out of Starduster. Fucking suck, man. Contemplating not helping your team when you're targeting a Palpatine completely fails. Suck, man. All I want is this decrepit Nine-Um main, but you insist on being shitty. And Nine-Um rage quit as soon as I said that. Nine-Um knew that Starduster was going to be completely and utterly useless, and knew that he was going to be ruthlessly hunted down by wizardly old men who want nothing more than to destroy his kind. Or wait, did NA Schemer take... No, wait. N.A. Simder, or whatever his fucking name is, took Nine-Um, and then the Nine-Um made rage quit. That's fucking... Oh. You love to fucking see it, man. This fucking shitty Nine-Um main's getting what they deserve. Take great joy, please. That a fucking shitlord's getting... Starduster now wants to be completely and utterly useless. Not like he wasn't being useless already. Maybe teabag that Nine-Um. Let's go get this fucking Luke. Oh. You're doing that, Starduster? Alright, dude. Fuck. Yeah! Oh shit, I got knocked down. Starduster's really pissed that he's not allowed to camp up there. Where's my bonus shot? There you go. Can he not? I guess he can't jetpack. Up there. If you're so desperate to be useless,
Morte de covarde.
I probably couldn't time that right. So his whole plan was to target me. It completely and utterly failed, by the way. And then, fucking hear you. Legit got lost far, far away.
Vocês vão todos morrer.
Saw a soldier down here. Where'd he go? Where is he? TL-50 glitching Starduster? No fucking way, right? That'd be insane if he was. But... You thought I was AFK, is that it?
Oh, we'll
just kill him, though. No, Starduster. Oh, he is doing it. Spreading a very lengthy message. I missed that. Stardust's whole plan is to harass the Orson, but I'm gonna attack this fucking Orson in my life. How's I have pain this whole time? Some people seem like they're fucking confused, about, like, lab video. Or more so people think that I only beat them when they're TL50 glitching, but we would have beaten lab without it, you know? Like, lab's fucking terrible. I don't know how else to put it. He's dog shit. Lab is a very, very bad player who is carried, but, like, Punisher is better than him. Ex-Papa is better than him. Everybody in his fucking clan is 1,000%. Yeah, Atari Dylan's probably fucking better than him. You know? These people are really fucking shit. And Punisher keeps it up. Punisher's whole thing doesn't make any sense either, because the whole point is to fuck with Lab. Like, it's not about his fucking plan. I could give a hot shit about Deathwatch. Now, look at that. Stardust fucking failed. Who would have thought that he would have quit?